So today we are going to talk about norms of a vector. Now what is this norm? If we see, a norm is a sort of mapping of a vector 1, 2, 3 plus I, anything, to a value. So, what is the space of this? 3 dimension. So, it belongs to series to the power n, whatever is the dimension, to some real value. This way of mapping is called a norm. Of course, there are various properties. So the properties which must be satisfied of a norm are that a norm of a vector must be equal to zero if and only if vector itself is a zero. Zero vector. Like for example, let us for simplicity consider a simple like 2 second order norm. Let me explain. For example, 1 minus 1, 0. Now what will be the norm of it? Second order norm of this vector will be 1 square plus minus 1 whole square under root, which will be under root of 2. So here the second order norm of this vector is root 2. In a similar way, there are multiple, this is 2, there are multiple levels of norm. This is the first property. Then the second property which we need to satisfy for norm, for the second order norm is, I'm not sure if it is visible. Okay, let me write here only. Then the second property which is important for the second order norm is alpha of x is alpha times lambda. You can verify it, it's very simple to verify. You can just take an example and just do it. The third and important property is norm at x plus 1 must be less than or equal to norm at x plus norm at 1. This is what do we call this kind of an inequality? We call such inequality as triangular inequality. So now we have listed these three properties. The first is that it must be zero if and only if the vector is zero vector. So, the second property is that a scalar multiple of a vector is always the scalar times the norm. The third property is that it should satisfy the triangular inequality. So, after these three properties of norm, let me dig deep into what actually is a norm. These are Liebig norms about which I am trying to talk about. Liebig, let me explain. If you know about vector space, so similarly, now let me talk up specifically about LP norm. The because this will be useful when we will study QR factorization and other concepts, SVD and this householder and all those stuff in the later lectures. So now, if we see what is an LP norm, if we dig deep into it, yes, I guess now it is clearer. What? No, if we deep into what is LP norm, it is nothing. Let me take an example. Now this is a vector. Let me take it first. Okay. Now, if I have to find the first order norm, then it will be nothing but summation. Mod of x. This is first order now. Okay? Of this. Which, so in this case we call it L1R. L1R. Okay? In the second L1R. Then if we take the second order norm of the same vector, let me take it minus, and for making it a bit twisted, let me take it 3 plus, so that it looks a bit nice, in sense that we can understand actually how the complex is actually mapped to real. Now if we take second order norm, by definition, it will be okay. Now here it is n. N is equal to 3 plus 1. Now, what will be its norm? Just tell me. What is mod of x I whole square? Individually. So what is 1? This will be 1 square plus 2 square. Plus 9 plus 2. Now this mod of it whole square, what will it be? This into its conjugate. So 9 plus 1, 10, okay? Would it be this or anything else? Because so if I take it like this, then it will be 15 under root of 15. So this is nothing but second order. And similarly, there is something called a third order now. And nth order. So now, if I keep on extending these orders of norm, for any pth order norm, the formula will be summation I is equal to 1 to n mod of xi raised to the power p whole raised to the power 1 by p. This will be nothing but pth order norm. Okay? So now, if you see, tell me, there is a question which I want to ask you, very crucial question. If I take infinite order norm, the last L will L infinity R, what will it be? What will it be? Just a try. Okay. Summation I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 1 raised to the power infinity. Plus 2 raised to the power infinity plus root of 10 raised to the power infinity Why is it root of m? Because remember, what will be the mod of this vector? 3 plus I, 3 minus I, under root of it, which will be nothing but 9 plus 10, 9 plus 1, 10. So under root of 10 raised to infinity, raised to the power 1 by 10. Okay, have you seen something called what we tell, order of convergence? Similar to order of convergence, which will be, suppose I take 1 to the power 5, okay, 1 to the power n, what will be the 1 to the power n? This is n and this is a to the power n, okay. Now if I take 1 to the power n, it will be something like this. If I take, let me draw a bigger diagram because this is something which is very important. If I take, this is n, this is a to the power n. This is 1, what is 1 to the power, 1 to the power 1, this 1, so it will be straight. If I take 2 to the power 1, what will it be? First, initial it will be 2, 2 to the power 2, so 2 to 2, so it will be an exponential, okay? Okay, it will be an exponential with 1 at 0, 2 to the power 2. Now, if I take 3 to the power n, it will be an exponential, it will be greater than this. And we can always say that 3 to the power n is always greater than 2 to the power n for n greater than 0. Is it so? So in that sense, when we go to an infinite space, out of these 3, which will be the one that dominates? Will it be 1 to the power infinity, will it be 2 to the power infinity, or will it be root 10 to the power infinity? Obviously, it has to be root 10 to the power infinity, because it is, see, root 10 is approximately 3 point something something, which is greater than 2, which is again, 2 is again greater than 1. So, when we get to infinity, we can neglect these two. Okay? And so, the norm will become root 10 to the power infinity upon infinity, which gets to summation, because we have already done summation, so there was no need of summation, but just understand what I mean. This root 10 to the power infinity raised to the power 1 upon infinity, so the answer will get to the power, get this. This will be the answer. So, in short, if we have any vector 1, 2, 3 plus I or 3 plus minus I, anything, then first order norm is nothing but summation of all of them. Second order norm, if we see, is simply inner the absolute value, normal way of thinking. And if we go infinite order norm, then it will actually become the maximum of x i. This is the infinite, because at infinite order norm, out of these 3, whichever is the greatest will raise to the power infinity will be dominant, and upon raise to the power 1 upon infinity, then it will balance, counterbalance. So this is a very basic overview of what is LP norm. And now we will further dig into it and try to understand what by graphical geometric representation. Rather than representation, it would be interpretation. Geometric interpretation.
Yes, to meet our requirement.
Or in rather norm spaces. Now let us try with an example. You know two dimension. This is even. Why is it even? What is x here? X is something. What is the basis? Now what is basis, you know now? Basis is nothing but whatever forms it. So this is 1 comma 0. Its basis is vector 1 comma 0. Okay. And here it is 0 comma 1. So if I represent it as a vector, it will be 1 0. And what will be this as a vector? It will be 0 1. Okay. So a basis is nothing but a vector divided by its magnitude, and both of which span the whole vector space. Now what is spanning? I guess you must understand it in a way that any linear, what is spanning means, for example, you are like this point. Now this point can be represented as this plus this, some combination of this. This is nothing but spanning. So spanning means just take some combination of vector, some cocktail of this vector. This vector, this combination, this vector, this combination, and every point of that space gets covered. So that's what we tell, that these two vectors have spanned the whole space and they are basis of this whole vector space. So we can say the 0, 1 and 1, 0 are the basis of it. And rather, to be specific, we name it E1 and E2. Elementary basis, okay? Because they are most obvious ones. So now, if we see this item, this E1 and E2. Now what will I do? I want all the vectors which are same now. First order now. Okay, let me get it. All such vectors. So which will be there? Now this is x, this is y. And let me for now consider it as real. So this will be mod of x plus mod of y is equal to one kind of vector. So if we see such vectors, let me make it clear. This one here will actually form something like this. Why? See, x plus y, this equation is x plus y is equal to 1. This equation is minus x plus y is equal to 1. This equation is minus x minus y equal to 1. Let me see. I put correct. And this equation is x minus y is equal to 1. So in a sense, I can also tell it that mod of x plus mod of y is equal to 1. This is satisfied, okay? Here also mod x plus mod y is equal to 1 is satisfied. Here also mod x plus mod y is equal to 1 is satisfied, and here also. So if you take all of them, this will be the boundary of all of them. So this is what we call locus of this equation. Okay. If I take second order now, is equal to 1. This is interesting. You must understand this. This will give me equation mod of x whole square plus mod of y whole square is equal to 1. Now just think, what should it be? Have you seen such equation before? X minus h whole square plus y minus t whole square is equal to 1. Isn't it something very familiar? Does something strike you? It is circle. Now, the second order norm will be nothing but, for a constant second order norm, you will get circle. Previously, you got this way. And if you go further, mod of x whole cube plus mod of y whole cube is equal to 1, you will actually start approaching something slowly from this. This is 2, this is 3. Actually, you are trying to approach this idea, infinite order now. Just tell me what will be the infinite order now. Mod x is equal to 1 and mod y is equal to 1. Or wouldn't it be so? Just think for it one second. Because only if this is satisfied, mod of x is equal to 1, and for any y, the answer would be 1. Suppose 0.5. Because 1 to the power infinity, for infinite order norm, I'm trying to say, okay? So, for an infinite order norm, if x to the power infinity has to move to the power infinity raised to the power 1 by infinity, if I see mod, it is equal to 1 only if mod of x is equal to 1 or mod of y equal to 1. This 1 to the power infinity plus 0.5 to the power infinity raised to the power 1 by infinity. In long run, this will be very less than this, so answer will be 1. If you take 0.8 instead of 1, you take 0.8 to the power infinity plus 0.5 raised to the power infinity, then 0.5, then answer would be 0.8. So in a sense, just think about it for a while. The answer would be either mod x equal to 1 or mod x equal to 1. Getting it? So in that case, the answer would be something like that. So let us compare. First order norm is equal to 1. This. Second order norm, you got a circle. Third order norm, we would get something like this. Okay. And for infinite order norm, you will get perfect square. So this is how we can represent infinite order norms. And from Z1 to infinite, okay? Anyway.